Hi everyone, in the last video, we learned how to create an advanced health bar UI. In this video, we will add the health bar to the player and we will incorporate damage and healing features for the player through the health control system we will create. In this video, you will learn a health control system and you can customize it for your project. Okay, let's get started. I have created a sample scene like this. In the scene, we have a player, a moving spike, and a tile map. The tag of the spike object is obstacle. Let's start the game in this state. As you can see, when the player hits an obstacle, player dies and respawn from the starting point. There is a game controller script on the player. With this script, we detect the player's contact with the obstacle and control the dying and respawning process. Let's create a health bar UI first. Right click on the hierarchy panel and create an image. When we create any UI object, a canvas object is added automatically. Select the image and set the position to the middle. The canvas area and the game scene area are different from each other. I will rename the object to background and change its size. And I will change the color to black. Then duplicate it using the Ctrl D shortcut. I'm gonna name it fill and change the color to green. I'll drag and drop the fill object on the background object. I'll slightly reduce the size of the fill object. I'm gonna drag and drop the Y square sprite into the source image slot to activate the image type feature. Change the image type to filled. And change the fill method to horizontal. We'll change the fill amount value using the health control script. When we start the game, the health bar stays fixed on the screen. Let's fix the health bar on top of the player and have it move along with the player. I'll change the name of the canvas to health bar. Drag and drop the health bar onto the player object. And change the render mode of the canvas to world space. Reset the position. As you can see, the health bar is quite large compared to the player. Let's reduce the size of the health bar to better fit the player. I will change the Y position of the health bar so that it's positioned above the player. Great! Now the health bar moves along with the player. I'll create a health controller script on the player object. Open the health controller script. I'm gonna create float variables named max health and current health. And before the game starts, I will set the current health value equal to the maximum health value. I'll create an image variable to access the image of the field. I've created a take damage method and I'll call it when the player touches the obstacle. I use the method mathclamp to keep the current health value between 0 and maximum health value. If the current health value drops to 0, I will call the die function. Open the game controller script. I'll change the die function to public to access it from the health controller script. I'll cut this method from here and paste it into the health controller script. I'm gonna create a game controller variable to access the game controller script. I'll call the take damage function when the player touches the obstacle. You can give the parameter value directly, but I'll create a variable for this purpose. When the current health value is 0, I'll call the die function in the game controller script. I'm gonna create a function named update health bar. And change the full amount value of the health bar fill object like this. I'm gonna call the function after the player takes damage. Okay, save the script and go back to Unity. Drag and drop the health bar fill image to the slot. And drag and drop the player here to access the game controller script. And set the damage amount. Start the game. You can create a damage animation if you want. When the player turns, the health bar also turns. Let's fix the rotation of the health bar. To solve this, I will change the rotation of the health bar to the rotation of the camera. Drag and drop the health bar object to the slot. Start the game again. Nice, the rotation of the health bar is fixed. After the player respawns, the current health value is still equal to 0. Let's solve this problem. To do that, I will set the current health value to the maximum health value after the player dies. Great! Let's now create a healing system. I have created this health image and I will drop it onto the scene. Set the size and position of the object. I'm gonna add a tag to the object named health. And I'll add a circle collider. Enable is trigger feature of the collider. I'm gonna create a new method named heal. I'll call the heal function when the player touches the health object. I have created the health amount variable to set it in the inspector panel. You can set the health amount value as you want. Okay, let's start the game and test it. Oops, this way it's impossible for us to access the health object. So I will add an area effector to the scene. I'll use the area effector that we created earlier in this tutorial series. First, let's take some damage. As you can see, when the player touches the health object, their health increases. I wanna deactivate the health object after the player touches it. Nice! The health control system is ready. If you want, you can add animation to the health bar using the methods you learned in the last video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, see you in the next Unity tutorial.